All right, it's finally here. FluentCRM has released their official ThriveCart integration, so now we don't have to fuss with using third-party things like Zapier, Pabbly, Integrately, and all those kinds of tools. We can actually integrate right with FluentCRM as of 2.3.0. Let's look at how to do that. First thing you want to do is go into your ThriveCart account and go to API and Webhooks, and then go to API Keys, and then click Create API Key, give it a name, and copy that key. Then you'll come into your WordPress website, find FluentCRM on the left, find add-ons, and we're looking for the Fluent Connect add-on. As it says here, this is how FluentCRM and ThriveCart integrate together. Click Activate or Install, and then click View Settings. Next, we're going to connect our account. That's why we needed that API key. Go ahead and paste in your key, and then click Next. Now we need to come back into our ThriveCart settings, go to API and Webhooks again, go to Webhooks and Notifications, give it a name, I'll call mine FluentCRM, paste in your webhook URL that they gave you on the screen right after you entered your API key, then click Save This Webhook. You're not done yet. Now you need to come back into your WordPress website and find Fluent Connect. Go to the top where it says Data Connectors, and then click Add New Connector, and give it a name. We'll call ours ThriveCart, and click Continue. Now you should automatically see that, well, because Fluent Connect only has one integration right now, which is ThriveCart, and we have already connected it in the previous steps, you should see that your account has already appeared here, and then click Continue. Now it starts to resemble something like Zapier, where you select the event. So on, let's say, an order success on ThriveCart, now we select what product. Again, this is very similar to Zapier. We can choose any of our products. We can also choose any order bumps as well. So you can trigger events here in FluentCRM based off of order bumps, which is pretty cool. But let's say that somebody buys my Codeology Pro membership. What's going to happen? Then we can choose whether or not we want all of our product selections to be satisfied in order to run this rather than right? So if you added a bunch of different products and you didn't check this box, it would happen on this one or the next one or the next one. It wouldn't matter as long as one of those was satisfied. Here, if we check this box, it would say all of them have to be purchased in order to basically make this run. Since we have one product, we'll leave that unchecked. We can give this an internal label. So I could call this Purchased Codeology Pro. I can choose to activate this trigger, which moves it from draft state to published state. I think that's a little bit of a weird checkbox personally. We'll leave it in draft, but then we click save. And now, as you can see, we have our trigger, Purchase Codeology Pro, and we can say, okay, now I don't want this to be a draft. I want it to be activated. Again, I think that should just be like a dropdown on the right-hand side, but click save. So now that we have our trigger all set up and published, which again, I think is very strange because we're still on a draft up here because we haven't decided what the task is, but the trigger's done and published. Let's go now to our tasks and select FluentCRM, which is the only option at the launch of the plugin. Click continue, and then we choose an event. So for this event, I'm going to add them to a list or a tag. I'm going to choose list, and the list I'm going to choose is my Codeology Pro list, that they're added to the email list that Codeology Pro members receive. And I'm going to choose to subscribe them. And I'm going to give this an internal label, something that describes what's happening. So they're being added to the Codeology Pro list. That makes sense. And then sure, we can activate this action and click save. Now that both of these have been published, let's go ahead and publish our data connection. Now that we're adding people to a list, we can do things like create automations that trigger inside of FluentCRM when somebody is added to a list, or let's say we added them to a tag. In this case, we added them to a list, so we can give this a tag or a label and call this Codeology Pro Welcome. We can say, okay, what's going to trigger this when they're applied to a list? And we can choose which list. In this case, our purchase of Codeology Pro added our customers to the Codeology Pro list, and we'll click Save Settings. So now our automation starts when somebody purchases the product and gets added to our list, and we can decide what happens next. And now we're basically inside of FluentCRM, where we can build automations, and we can build email sequences, and we can send outgoing webhooks, basically all the great features of FluentCRM and all the reasons why we would use FluentCRM, we now have access to. So that's really it. That's how you connect ThriveCart to FluentCRM without the use of any external tools. If you're interested in learning more about FluentCRM and ThriveCart, be sure to head over to Codeology.com, where I have lots of other great tutorials, as well as here on the channel. That'll do it for me in this video, though. My name is Doug from Codeology, and I'll see you in the next video.